Hi, welcome back to Rebecca's Travels, or if you're watching my lifestyle channel, welcome back to Rebecca's Lifestyle. Today I've had a wonderful, lovely meal at the Cross Keys pub in Newbold Claughton. Yes, it was really nice with my family. And today's weather, well, it's been cloudy, but not that cold. So today I'm going to be doing a budget travel news special, 5 exciting facts, February 2022, part 1. This is according to budgettravel.com. And hi, if you're new here, my name's Rebecca. I love talking about travel and lifestyle. So please subscribe. It is free and I upload 5 times a week on both my travel and my lifestyle channel. So I hope everybody's as well as possible. So I'm going to fire away on how to save money when traveling from budgettravel.com, which is a tip 1. To drive is the easiest way for anyone, especially families, to save money when they travel, is to avoid the price of plane tickets if possible, and making your travel money go further, so you have more to spend when you're there. Driving allows you to see more of the country and have bonding time with your family, and prevents you from having to pay for rental cars or rideshare when you get to your destination. Remember to make sure your car is road trip ready before you leave, and to make sure insurance is up to date. Looking to save even more money is GETCO, could save you 15%, wow, or more on car insurance. And so that's a really good tip, especially at the end, because not only travel insurance you'll need if you're traveling and buy a car, then you will need car insurance if you're traveling by your own car. Again, driving does allow you to see more of the country, in any country, when traveling, if you have got your own car. And it will save you, particularly if you can get to your destination by car without it taking you too long. Obviously, for destinations that can't be reached by car, then obviously you will need to pay for a plane ticket. But there's ways that you can save on plane tickets as well. Number 2, use a scanner alert. If your destination is too far away for a road trip, we recommend you using Sky scanner alerts to make sure you get the best price on airline tickets. Sky scanner lets you enter your departure and arrival destination, and will email you alerts when the price drops, which is really good news. It will also let you explore the prices by date and by month, so you can make sure when you are going, your flight is the cheapest or the cheapest as possible for when you do want to travel or when you can travel. Tip number three is take advantage of the shoulder season, at the time between the destination's peak season and off season or low season is known as the shoulder season. The shoulder season allows you to experience at some destinations' best offerings without the crowds and for at cheaper rates, which is really good news, especially on your wallet. To determine when the shoulder season is for a destination you have in mind, to find out the peak, you need to Google the to find out the peak season, when the peak season is, then start researching the months that bookend the peak for prime family destinations such as DC or Florida beaches. Save money by looking around during the times when schools are not on a break, and if you have not got obviously any school age children, because obviously in the UK you can't take your children out of school, but if you haven't got any children then it is a bonus, because you're not tied to the school holiday period. The shoulder season is a great time to have a more laid-back travel experience and to save money as well. Tip four, buy travel insurance. The advice is to buy travel insurance so you can counter the productive of this list of money-saving tips. Well, it can be counterproductive, but it is advisable to buy travel insurance, since the insurance will raise the cost of your trip. That's why it's counterproductive, but consider how much extra expense could be added to your budget if something goes wrong, especially if you have to go into hospital in an expensive country for hospital costs like America. They really charge the earth if it's something simple as locking the keys into your rental car will cost you $200 to fix in America. Travel insurance will cover the costs of any unintended emergencies and will give you peace of mind to enjoy your trip without any necessarily nagging worries about expensive. Also, it can cover, like, if your luggage gets lost or damaged for some reason as well, or if anything again get stolen, and again policies vary, so for exactly what your travel insurance covers it's better to check your policies and also what you need in your travel insurance. Obviously if you have extra ski equipment etc, then that's extra on top of your travel insurance, or anybody with any pre-existing medical problems, you would have to pay extra. But again, it's best to check around for travel insurance to find the best policy for you. But again, it's better to take it just in case something goes wrong. Tip five, book with points. Travel credit cards allow you to earn points for everyday purchases. that you can use towards booking travel. Look for credit cards specific to travel. We really like the Chase Sapphire card and the Southwest Airlines card. You will even get extra points if you are able to recommend them to a friend. Like all credit cards, make sure you have a plan to pay them off in full at the end of each month, or again whenever you use them. So it just applies like all credit cards. Well, I would like to say thank you for watching, and I hope everybody is as well as possible. And I'll see you on Sunday for an improvements updates and more video. And I would like to say bye for now. Thank you. Bye.